All right, fellas, what is going on? It is a Sunday. Sundays are usually a pretty relaxed day for me, and so I thought it'd be a perfect day to film a training vlog for you guys and see more into my training, how I structure it and everything. Today, I've got a leg day, and I'm basically just starting things off with some pre-workout. 30 minutes before, I've got some granola, because it's quite early in the morning and I haven't really eaten much today. So yes, and granola, basically just something light, milk in it. Something that doesn't sit in my stomach for too long and is easy to digest, so that way I'm not feeling like full and like I'm gonna vomit on a hard leg day, you know. And so basically you just want something that is doesn't sit in the stomach for too long, but you want to go to training not feeling like with a proper empty stomach. You don't want to be feeling like you're starving, and so something light. And also something that is I'm going to show you guys a little trick for those of you guys who are struggling to kind of get new habits or get something, or maybe even you're like me, you're just trying to get your creatine in on a regular basis. A good way to secure a new habit is to add it to something that you already do on a daily basis. So say you're trying to take creatine on a daily basis. One of my friends, he has tea on a daily basis, and what he does is he just puts his creatine in his tea. So say if you're a coffee person, you can maybe put creatine in your coffee. If you're a pre-workout person, I don't take pre-workout, but if I did, I would probably put creatine in my pre-workout. And this is basically what I take on a daily basis, usually 30 minutes before my workout. It is orange juice is carbs. I put salt in it for a better pump in my workout, and I also put creatine in it so that I can take creatine on a regular basis without having to worry about it too much, because I know I'm gonna have orange juice, and I just remember, oh, I'm gonna have orange juice, put creatine in it, and it's become a regular habit. So something that is very easy to do, put, if you're looking to create a new habit, add it to something that you already do. But yeah, I'm gonna have this orange juice, and then that is me pretty much done eating, and I'm gonna hit my workout. Once I'm done hitting my workout, I will come back right here and I'll do a voiceover for you guys and kind of talk through my training. All right, let's go. All right, boys, on to the leg day voiceover. So I'm pretty much just gonna go over the structure of my leg day and why I structure it the way it is. Starting off, man, just start off with a good warm up. A lot of guys, they do their workouts and they don't warm up, which just doesn't make sense to me. Something I learned when I started training is, I'm gonna go a bit scientific on you guys for a second, but basically there's this thing inside our body called synovial fluid, which basically it's kind of sticky and hard at first, but when you warm up, when you get your muscles and your legs kind of warmed up, that synovial fluid, it basically turns a bit gooey and it acts as lubricant for our joints. So after learning that, you know, it's kind of obvious like why you should warm up. You want to lubricate your joints so that you don't get hurt. So it's kind of a mandatory thing. So if you're not warming up, I don't care why you're not warming up, whether it's an ego thing, a time thing, or something else. If you're going to lift heavy, if you're going to push the weights, warm the fuck up, because you don't want to get injured in the gym. That is one of the worst things that can happen to you. And an injury is actually something I've been going through right now, which I will talk about in just a second. Well, yeah, this is some of my warm-up. This is not the full warm-up. I did some other stretches, but I just didn't film them. Also spent some time walking on the treadmill just to gain some body heat. But yeah, I like to start my leg days off with a compound of sorts. So either a deadlift or a barbell squat. My barbell squat is on the other leg day, and this leg day I start off with a deadlift. So I basically squat and I deadlift once per week. I'm actually going through a forearm injury right now, so I can't really grip and lift things that heavy. So I tried to deadlift today just to see how my grip was. My grip was absolute dog shit. So I just left the deadlift, and I replaced the deadlift today with a hip thrust, which we'll see later. But yeah, after you've done your deadlift, you can do your deadlift with like 1 to 5 reps. If you want to focus on strength, or if you want to focus more on size, you can go like 5 to 8 rep range. I don't like to go too high on the deadlift rep range, because people end up getting gassed out because of cardio. But yeah, after you've done your deadlifts, that's your hamstrings, your hips, and your back kind of, you know, dealt with. And then now we're moving on to quads with the leg press. And I like to mix machines and barbells. I feel that's kind of just the best. As well, the leg press is just great for absolutely hammering the quads. You also get some adductor work in there as well for the inner portion of your legs, the thighs. And that's really going to beef up your legs. But yeah, back to the machines versus barbells thing. You're going to see in the fitness industry, people argue over one or the other. And man, I'm just like, both have a shit ton of benefits. The barbell has benefits. The machines have a ton of benefits. Why not just mix them together and have both in your workout? It just seems obvious to me. And that is how I've gotten the best results. That is how my clients have gotten the best results. So I just mix them both together. I don't see a need to go full all in on one or the other. You know, you get the stability benefits, the mobility benefits, the real life strength benefits, and a bunch of more benefits from barbells. And you get the benefits from machines of just honing in specifically on that one muscle and really being able to take it to muscular failure without cardio being a limiting factor. So why not use both? Well, yeah, then we got the, I don't know what to call this machine. You could call it a hip thrust machine. I could call it the Thruster 9000. But yeah, doing hip thrusts here. And this has been really good for me as well. Good replacements for the deadlift since I can't use my hands at the moment. Otherwise, I would just do the deadlift. And that's what I would recommend to most people. And then, yeah, moving on to some isolated muscle work. I think this is important, you know, for the muscles that are struggling to develop on your body. I think you do want to isolate them. So whether that's your hamstrings, isolate them, work them more per week. Whether that's your quads, isolate them. My quads have been growing pretty well. So I just done the leg press, you know, compound movements for my quads, but my hamstrings take more work. This is why I'm doing hamstring curls, to give them more isolated work. And as a general rule, I like to work my body parts twice per week. That works for me. And if I need to, if they're not growing as much as I would like them to work, then or as like them to grow, then I might increase the frequency to 2 times per week. But yeah, this is the Thigh Clapper 9000, we'll call it. This also isolates the inner thigh, the adductor of your legs. If you've never isolated that portion of your legs before, I highly recommend trying this machine. This machine is not only for girls, it is for everyone. And it does a great job as growing that inner portion of your legs. Really like beefed up my legs. And then from there, guys, isolating the other body parts. So like calves and abs. Man, if you skip calf day, then what are you doing, man? Like calves are just a must in my opinion. They really complete the physique. They complete the legs. And you know, if I pull my pants down, I don't want a girl to see that I have no calves. So calves is one of those things I think you should train. But yeah, after this, just did some abs, and then after the abs, that is basically my leg day complete. I feel training abs on a leg day is really productive. They just don't seem to fit well in my other days. On my upper body days, I prefer to just do like neck training or forearm training. I feel that is a good structure. But yeah, guys, this video is going to end. It's coming to an end, and this is pretty much all recorded. I should have recorded more. I'll probably do it next time. But yeah, hope you guys found this helpful. This is how I generally structure my leg day. It has been a massive help for me. And if you found that helpful, subscribe. Peace out.